Hello everybody, welcome back to Minecraft on the Block. This is the Crafters Minecraft FTB server, and I am ready to build an industrial blast furnace actually today. So I went ahead and did some prep work, but I wanted to do the actual building with you guys on camera, and then we'll do some more stuff. I'm thinking potentially today about ways to make this building less ugly. So I've got some people that agree with, I mean, it kind of grows on me a little bit as I've been here a while. I know it's not like the most beautiful building in the world. And it's funny because, yeah, I don't know. It's not the most beautiful building in the world. I probably should have, I don't know what I should have done. In fact, there was a couple of things I was going to do originally, and I might do some things to try and to fix it. But a couple of things that I know I want to do are like, I want to change the what it's sitting on. I think that will help. I think it's sitting on this grass makes it look ridiculous. I need to put some kind of exoskeletal structure to it. That's not even really the word I'm looking for at all. I need like some awnings and different things like that. It's just not a good looking building, so we might try to fix it. But you know what? I spent a lot of time on it. You can't win them all. There's been very few buildings in my... That's not true. There's been a lot of them that I didn't like at first. There's been very few that I just haven't been able to fix at all, so that I just hated it forever. And we'll see. Maybe this will be one of them. But it's unique, at least. You know where you are when you're in this building. And I like being able to see out, and I like my little lab. There's a lot of things I like, but there's a lot I don't like. Anyway, two things I want to get to before we even get into it. I was going to... I got a couple of comments, one that I wanted to share last time, and I forgot. And that was from Pop Rock Set Coke. And he said that if you spacebar and click, you'll empty a project table. So if you like put some stuff up here to do whatever and then spacebar click. Ah, it does work. You have to do it on one of the items. And it unfortunately seems like it empties it into your inventory, which is too bad. What if we did like spacebar right click? No. Huh. Well, that works, but it empties it into your inventory, which I guess is okay. Yeah, whatever. No problem. Anyway, so that's one thing. Let's see. I'm going to get rid of some of this stuff. This is going to be difficult, I know already. But anyway, okay, so that was one thing. So thank you, Pop Rocks at Coke. Works with chests to move your whole inventory in one go. So if I like space click in here, it will move everything into the chest. I don't want to try that right now, but that's interesting too. So thank you for that. The other one was a comment from, I hope I don't butcher your name, I think it was Ole Hansen or Ole, O-L-E Hansen, H-A-N-S-E-N. Ole Hansen told me that iron gates will also work with pipe wire. The difference is that you have to use red pipe wire, and you can only use the red one. I did not know that. I had tried when I was trying to use iron gates, I was using it with green and yellow and whatever. So that's interesting. So that means that you could get away with, if you only wanted one condition that you would have to fulfill for the gate, then you could totally use red, or I mean, you could totally use iron. So in this case, we would have had to use at least gold. Wait a minute. I still think that's right. Gold gates, you can do two different color wires, and then the diamond can work with all four, which makes sense. So apparently I wouldn't be able to get yellow on this one. I just maybe got lucky. Maybe it's like red, blue, and then yellow. I don't know. Anyway, so there's some information for you. If you want to use pipe wire to do like the redstone signal thing, but only need one condition to be met, you could use iron. And use red pipe wire. So that was the other thing I wanted to point out. And thank you, Ole Hansen. And correct me if I got your name wrong. Sorry about that. Okay, I prepped everything that I need, I believe, for the industrial blast furnace. A couple of things I wanted to point out. Oh, the other thing I should probably show you. Let me just... I'm having a problem right now. I moved red power in here. I guess, yeah, let me show you all this stuff. So I've set up another bank of engines. I've got two banks now of engines going. And you can see that a couple of them aren't even running, and a couple of them... So I'm basically running what right now? 7 out of the 12, so just over half of them. So I'm really only running one more than I was running before. And I had it up to where I was running all but two, so I was running 10 of them. The problem is that there's a noisy zombie I'm going to have to take care of. The problem is that I had an issue out here, and I haven't been able to recover from it fully. The issue was that a tree grew. This used to come in on the top right there. And a tree grew and broke this. It grew right into here. So from here, it grew right in and broke that, which I didn't even think was possible. But anyway, it broke the saplings being able to get here. And so it stopped planting, and the system just shut down. And that was right after I put in the additional engines. And now I haven't been able to recover, because I even went and got like a, I don't know, like maybe 20 or 30 and put them in this thing and tried to get it to go, and it just can't catch up. It's basically, it's splitting them. I mean, you can see that it's putting some over here and some in here. But it needs, with all of those engines running, I need to have a lot of saplings going. So I might need to get something like the catalyst or something, which you can use with a forester. And I'm not sure. Catalyst is pollen and whatever, right? I don't know. In a wax capsule, which I don't have any of. I guess you can use a can, though, as well, so you can get catalyst, but that takes honey drops. Is there any recipe that doesn't take honey drops? Bone meal and pollen. So where do I get pollen from? I don't know where to get pollen from. Anyway, supposedly if you use catalyst, and I don't really know, I guess the forest, I'm going to have to look into it, but the forester is, no, it's a forest hive. There's the forester. I don't totally know what it does. Maybe it's just a like an advanced version of the arboretum, and I think it does a larger area, but I really all I want is just what I've got with more growth. But anyway, rambling. All right, so that's one. See, that was great. I just knocked that down and I don't even get it back. That was dumb. Every sapling counts at this point. Anyway, so there's that. I did run red power wire in, and I ran it in and ran it right to here, and then came out of that with the transformer up, and this is my blue electric alloy furnace, just because I needed to make some of that red wire so that I could set up the additional bank, so I have a switch. The other thing to keep in mind here is these would normally connect, but I just ran this, which is just a panel strip right down on the edge of this block, and it just keeps these from connecting. It's just like if you put a cover or something between them, they won't connect. So that's just a way that you could use redstone wires right next to each other, or red wire right next to each other. So now we're back up to 8 of these things running. Let's see if we can get even more. Had to make some more of these. So I really do like my setup. I mean, it's allowing me to do the things I want to do. My little lab is really useful for, you know, I mean, being able to reconfigure things quickly. I can switch these pipes around and get red, you know, get some molten redstone in here and make some more of those and whatever. So, and getting, ooh, wow. I didn't realize I did that. I wanted to make obsidian and I apparently made a lot. Good. Excellent work. Okay. So, yeah. Then, is that all I needed to tell you guys about? I think so. So then, next step is, I just love these things. Next step is getting all this stuff ready. So, a couple of things I wanted to say. I've been messing around with the different, like, alternatives to using circuits, like electric circuits. And it's actually really handy because they take rubber and copper, which can be things that you don't have, but you can make an iron ore gate instead. And in fact, you can actually just make a redstone chipset. So like, let's go look at the standard machine casing. The recipe for standard machine casing takes either an electronic circuit or an iron gate or, wait for it, redstone golden chipset, right? A redstone golden chipset's easy to make. It's gold and redstone, literally gold and redstone. And I think each one takes 40,000 maybe, or maybe even 80,000. I think it's 40,000, so it takes a while, but you can just throw them in there, put a chest next to it, and it will just do its thing. And especially if you got added a couple more engines, so I'm running up really close to 30 Minecraft joules is what this thing takes when it's run at full rate now. And so they go pretty quick, but that's better. Even with the extra time that it takes, if you got the power, it's definitely better than making than using copper, because you take it takes so much copper. It takes 3 copper and 6 rubber just to get one of those circuits, and you need so many of them. Like for this, I need 18 of them, and here I need another couple. And so, anyway, you guys get the point. So let's go ahead and make the standard machine casings first. I thought this would be kind of a fun way to do this. So I'm going to make those. I need 9 because I need a total of 34, and I am right in between with the recipe, the number that you can make with a recipe. So we just need machine blocks. I went ahead and did that. You can actually do some alternatives there as well. You can make, you can make the aluminum machine hull, not a good alternative. Machine frame is probably a decent one. The sturdy casing is a decent one. Those other ones are kind of a pain because they take, like this one, takes machine parts. You get 16 of them from all this, so if you just made a few of these redstone golden chipsets and put some iron in, you could get 16 of them. That might actually be, especially if you're hard up for refined iron, this would probably be a better approach, because then you could just use, what does it say, aluminum, which I don't have aluminum, I don't believe. I mean, I've got all of that. I mean, I do have aluminum, but it's not in the form of ingots. It's all this. Can I smelt one of those? No, you can't like re-smelt it or anything. So I don't think that type of aluminum substitutes for anything that you would want. I think it has to be the other type. Anyway, I'm totally rambling. So I'm going to make 9 recipes. I needed to have 18 of these things. They go on either side, I believe, right? And then this stuff. So there we go, 36 of them. And let's go see about where we want to place those. What I've been thinking is kind of right over here. It's going to be a 1, 2, 3 by 3 and then 4 tall, I believe. So I kind of thought this would be a cool place. I want to do other stuff like that over here, so I don't know what other types of like built things I'll need. I have the coke oven and all that over there, which I'll probably just leave. I left the door open. Let's go ahead and sleep so we don't get killed. So I left I have the original blast furnace and the coke oven. The original blast furnace will never get used for another second, I don't guess, probably in its lifetime, but the coke oven will. So I could either move it over here or build another one. I'm not sure if it's worth. I just kind of like to have the machines around. So anyway, let's try this. What if we did like this? 1, 2, 3. Made this kind of the center. I could even go back as far as this and not leave as much walkway, but I kind of feel like right there is good. So let's just do that. Okay, so you put it. You fill the bottom. The next row has a hollow center. And I'm actually going to leave this one out too because we want to be able to put lava in there. And I'm not sure. I think I should be able to put the lava in there and then seal it. I don't know why I couldn't do that. I just think I remember seeing somebody do it, and they did not do it that way. They like tried to put them in the front or something, which didn't make a lot of sense to me. Anyway, we're going to replace these with better ones eventually. But so, 1 lava bucket, 2 lava buckets, and then like that. Now, I believe that is an industrial blast furnace. Now, we have to get the actual machine hooked up to it. So to do that, we need a couple of things. These are the parts for 2. These are the parts for 2 induction furnaces, which I have actually never built an induction furnace, interestingly enough. Let's get the Might as well pull up the blast furnace. So the induction furnaces are electric furnace, advanced machine blocks, and copper. So electric furnace, advanced machine blocks, and oh, I think I did. This is it right here. There we go. Two induction furnaces. And then those with this stuff will make me the actual blast furnace block. I have nickel, which is lucky. Something I probably wouldn't normally just have laying around because I don't even know where you get it. Well, it's from ferrous ore, I think. And it's a that's a byproduct. I've got almost three stacks of it. I had three stacks of it. That turns out to be a byproduct of... Do I have any more in here? I think... There's another stack. I think of the tin or iron smelting process. Probably the iron smelting or the iron pulverizing process. I think it's one of the things you get down here. So I've got a fair amount of that from all the stuff we've been doing. So that's nice to have around. I don't know if you find it. I have actually found ferrous ore as well. It's something you don't even recognize, or at least I don't until I get back to the shop. So anyway, we need these cupro nickel heating coils. We need two recipes full of this because you get three of each and we need four total, right? So it's going to be copper, and I'm going to use the, see, there's ferrous ingots too, which is, I don't understand. But anyway, copper and nickel. So we're going to do like that, and then oh, rolling machine, dummy. Oh, wait, space click, nice. Oh, and it brought those down, but it's not bringing these down. Interesting. Huh, anyway, no idea. Rolling machine, where's my rolling machine? There it is. So, there we go. Give me two of those. First time for everything. I've never built cupro nickel heating coils either. So I don't know if I told you guys this. I have been watching Ko's Quest. Like I'm on a episode like 110. I've watched from the very beginning. It's funny because it kind of coincided. There's been a little bit of a hype, it seems like, around his stuff. Did they get this fixed yet? No. Lately from the Minecrackers. I don't know why, but I think he's back doing videos, which is cool. And so anyway, I was watching, it coincided with me watching the Minecraft, what's the word I'm looking for? The Minecraft Story of Mojang, whatever, the documentary. And that got me really wanting to watch some like old alpha videos, like some of the original ones. Cause I remember seeing some videos, so here we go. We have our industrial blast furnace. I remember seeing some videos when I wasn't even playing, when I didn't even really know what Minecraft was. I remember seeing a couple of videos. I don't know how they came about, but something brought them up on YouTube, and I didn't even watch a lot of YouTube then. And I saw some guy playing and I was like, oh, that's interesting. And then the fact that he seemed to be like starting a new world all the time, and like, cause he went through and he was like all excited about clay. That's the thing I remember. I think I've told the story before, but anyway, something about it just didn't really click with me, but I could hear the excitement in his voice. I was like, what in the world? Like, this does not look like fun. I don't remember. I didn't pay enough attention, I guess, long enough. But anyway, I've tried to find that video multiple times. And I have not been lucky or haven't been successful in that. So, if anybody knows which one I'm talking about, you can point me to, let me know. But anyway, so I was looking for some alpha videos, and it just happened to be nice. Ooh. I like how these things like have actual number. Heat capacity, 1520. That's interesting, because that is definitely more. That's really cool. So it tells you, like, here's your block, and here's the things, and that's cool. And I think I can replace some of them, or I don't know if I have to replace entire levels with new types of blocks, but That's good. I think that will allow us to do what we need to do. I think we can do titanium in the industrial blast furnace, titanium dust at 15. So that's what we needed. We're just 50 over with our, because I think you get 500 from the lava, and I think the original was 1,050 heat capacity of these blocks without the lava. So that's cool. Now, I think this thing takes power. I don't think it's got any power. Like, I mean, it kind of looks like it's got power, but I don't think it does. Anyway, so the Coast Quest stuff, somebody mentioning that kind of coincided with me wanting to watch some alpha videos. So I went back and grabbed his first ones, and of course they were alpha. And he's still an alpha, actually. The Nether was just added. It's just cool to see somebody, like, see the somebody play through the progression of all the things that were added and, like, just kind of getting up to where we are now. So anyway, ramble. Yeah, so those Coast Quest videos are good. And he's playing an FTB series right now, which I'm going to have to go check out at some point with Anders, maybe, or somebody else. I don't know if it's Anders or who it is, but he's playing that. And it's not, as far as I know, it's not a Minecracker. I thought he was a Minecracker, and I could be wrong about that, but I thought he was. And I don't know if something happened with that, or, but he doesn't seem to be doing it now. So where am I going to run this cable? The fiber cable. I was thinking about just running it straight through. The question is, how much can this thing take? Does it tell me in 128? So I do need to come out of this thing here. So I wonder if I should just go underground. I thought it would be cool to have the cable coming down. But to do that, I would have to come out of here, and then this would be kind of a mess, because this is the straight stuff coming in. I mean, the best I think I could do would be to come, like, across and then up and then back down, which kind of seems silly the more I think about it. Let's see. Gotta get rid of the stupid pick. This unbreaking. These things never break. It's like having a crappy diamond pickaxe forever. And I have another one I gotta use up. Level 30, unbreaking 3. That's alright though. I'm not bitter. So let's go make a hole where we wanted to come back down. I'm just trying to think. I mean, this is kind of a bummer because I really did. I don't know why. I have things in my mind. I just like things a certain way. And what I like is the idea of that coming across and maybe coming down. But if anything, yeah, it just makes a lot of sense to just do it right here. I'm not going to dink with it. That's just silly. Somebody mentioned the other day, I don't know who it was, and I apologize for not having taken down your name. I was going to do that, but somebody mentioned that the possibility that the fermenter is somehow glitched, and it's glitched in such a way that it allows the fermenter to continue to run when you're not there, so the chunk isn't, I don't know, something weird. But the more I think about it, the more I wonder if that's really the case, if it's really the fermenter issue, because it seems like, where's my power? Right there. So we'll come down around and over. That's going to take more than I've got. And these are, yeah. So it seems like, what was I going to say? It seems like the fermenter is not the problem. It seems like it's, the fermenter doesn't maybe actually run. It's the engines that continue to run, even when I'm not on. That would kind of make more sense to me, but I have this same loop problem. I guess that's just the way it is. Nothing you can do about that. I don't think it's an issue either. And that's going to get in the way of me going up and down. I wonder if I should... Let's do this. I'll think about a different... Might as well get rid of this stuff here. Anyway, so yeah, ramble, ramble, ramble. Talk, talk, talk. Yeah, it looks like, so I was all excited. Circaz brought me back to Earth the other day. I was all excited because for some reason I thought that I had gotten one video that somebody had posted somewhere and seemed to have gotten a lot of views. And it turns out that apparently there was some glitch with mobile views and they were misreporting and something happened to Etho too. He got like a ton of views and it was something misreporting. I don't think it was actual views. So I think the same thing is true with my video. I don't think I actually got as many views as I had hoped that I had gotten. But anyway, a lot of people have been very kind and giving me a pat on the back saying it's going to happen eventually. And you know what? It may not. But it's still fun. And as long as it's fun, I think it's still fun because I know that I could quit anytime I wanted. And if I started getting a ton of views, it would be really much more difficult to actually quit if I needed to. So there's that. You got to look on the bright side of things. I mean, not that I'm thinking about quitting, but just if there was a reason to want to quit or take a break. I'm just really trying to think of things to say. This is why I do a lot of this stuff offline. I've been playing a lot of Legos. I need a couple more of those, so let's go get them. I've been playing a lot of Legos. I told you guys we went to the Lego store, which was really fun. And then, how do you do this? It's actually one, I think it's one diamond, and I want silver, is that right? I think silver's my best bet. Silver will yield 6. You could yield 8 if I had Electrum. Oh, I do have Electrum. Why haven't I been using Electrum? That's, what an idiot. I think I thought Electrum was hard to get or something. Electrum is not hard to get. Okay, new plan. Always use Electrum. There we go. And anyway, yeah, lots of Legos. And I love Legos. And my son turns out to be really good at it, which is cool. Not just like enjoys it and can do stuff, but he's actually very, very good at it. For being 4 years old, you can just sit him down with a kit and he can just do it with almost no help except for the physical stuff whenever he needs actual like physical help. Okay, so this doesn't look any different to me, so I wonder, if powering it is even necessary. I think you have to power that thing. I haven't paid enough attention maybe, but yeah, I mean it said in 128, so is that any different? Let's look at it real quick. What if we unpower it? Does it have a red dot? No, it looks no different to me. Oh well. Let's try to do something with it. I'm going to sleep so I can go grab. I think we left all of the like titanium dust next door. Sorry, I'm drinking coffee. That thing does look cool though. And it's kind of nice to not have the wire, I guess, running around, although I love that. I like the, I don't know, it sucks. I have still thought about, somebody had mentioned putting up some, like, iron girders, is that the right word? I think so. Which I haven't done. I'm still thinking about it, but I don't want to put a bunch of time and effort into this building if I'm never going to like it. So what I may do is just move on to the next one. I'm not sure what the next building is going to be. I don't know. I feel like it kind of bums me out that that's my lab. I like live and breathe that building and no one likes it, including me. There's some titanium. There's some aluminum. Got some bauxite. What else we got? Anything here that we want to take with us? No, we can live without the rest of this for now. Oh, I even had some electrum over here. I think I found that in a chest. This place is looking pretty empty. It never got the second story that it was meant to have. It does have the enchanting room, so I will always be going back there because I am addicted to enchanting. What else? What else is interesting? Yes, yeah, so the Legos. The Lego stuff is fun. I'm a little bit disappointed in the Lego kits that they have these days, at least most of them. I wish they had more, like big, lots of, like, you know, I don't know. Like, we got these dump truck kits. I bought 3 of them. It's funny because I got 2 of them I bought because I wanted each one of the kids to have them because they have big wheels, which I use to make these monster trucks, which sometime I'll have to like take a picture and show my monster trucks that I built. They have like independent actuating suspension on them. They're really cool. And anyway, so I got those dump trucks because they had good parts. I usually buy the kits for parts because the kids will build them and they'll use that, you know, they'll use them to build and have fun with. But then eventually it just goes into the gigantic Lego bin. What am I doing? And becomes the Lego tools or Lego kit. So I buy them for parts. I get kits that have, you know, good parts, and those kits had good parts. I got them two of them for Christmas, one for each. And then, it's actually working. The question is, would it also work without power? There's no way. Let's go see if it's actually pulling power. And then somebody else got him another one of the same kit, and I actually didn't take it back. I kept it because it was exactly, I mean, it was what I wanted. I would have just gotten them like 8 of those kits for Christmas or something. But so that is definitely pulling. This one's up to 2 million. These should both be at 10. Yeah, but it is pulling. You can see. So that's good. Okay. Oh, I made another 2 MFSUs. So we've got a total of, 40 million EU storage right now. Since I can't get Iridium to make the A, whatever, the other ones. All right, we're almost ready to get one piece of this. I don't know if... I'm assuming it's just taking as much as it needs, so this is just how long it takes, but there we go. We have a titanium ingot. So now I believe we can make... which I just really don't even care about that much right at the moment, the diamond drill. Now I can totally just make a diamond drill, be easy to do. And we might as well go ahead and do it since we have plenty of diamonds and diamond dust and whatnot, and we'll have a couple of titanium ingots. But the reason I say it doesn't really matter is because I'm just not using my my miner over there very much, and that's what I was going to use it for, was to speed up the miner. It's just the miner has become a pain. What I need to do is maybe look into... the Red Power, what's it called? I think I did this before. It's not rails. It's like the, what is the motor? Let's see. This thing. Frames. Red Power frames. So if we were to look at some frames, I think you can make these support frames. I think you make tube frames that have tubes in them. And you can make redstone tube frames. And you can make a frame motor, and you can get these things to move, right? So what I was thinking, it would be cool to set up like an automated system where like you could cue the turtle to go clear an area, and then the frame would move the miner to the new area, right? But I mean, you would have to get it would have to be a really, really elaborate system. And I'm just not there yet. I'm not where I want to put that kind of time. I mean, I will do that for fun, but right now I'm so behind on getting started on our buildings and stuff that I really just want to, I think you can do aluminum in this. Maybe you can't. Let's take a look. Aluminum ingots in an, ooh, they take 1700, see? So let's look at the potential for this right now. So anyway, titanium we got. We don't have aluminum. So this will get us titanium, and it will get us the silicone things if we want for solar panels. Actually, let's look at that real quick. If we look at solar, to get regular solar, we need these silicon plates. The rest of this is easy. In fact, we can use the redstone golden chipsets, which I'm going to go ahead and get a bunch of those going because those are good to just have around as an alternative, and they just take so little effort. Let's just make a bunch of them. Let's just dump... let's just dump those in, make the redstone golden chipsets. Yeah, they take 40,000 MJ each, but this thing's running at almost, it's not running that well right now because my engines are still not powered up. But anyway, those will turn out. They'll be fine. How many have I got running right now? Back to 7. I'm getting some. It's just a really a pain. Yeah, this my system is just not, it won't support 10, or it won't support 12. At least not in its current state. Maybe if it catches up, let's go take a look at it real quick. I don't even know how much time we have left. I'm kind of just, this is a fun episode. This is the way I like to make them, just kind of do stuff and not worry about it. So yeah, we're almost full back with these. I think if the system was running normally, see how there's all these saplings missing, and it's getting ready to plant some. It's going to plant a couple more right now. Probably fill in, I don't know where it's going to put them. wherever, put them somewhere. But the point is, this system is just, I mean, ever since it got behind like that, I ought to go just like tear down a bunch of stuff and get saplings for it. Like if I could get a stack in each of these, I think I would get back to where I need to be. But yeah, you can see that thing's running. It's going to probably be running at like 24 at best right now. Because the thing downstairs, the magma crucible downstairs is going to be running now that we're pulling power, trying to fill up. Well, it's going to be running anyway, trying to fill up those. So yeah, it's running like around 23, whatever. It made one of them already, so it'll make a bunch of them. Anyway, sorry, sidetracked. What was I going to say? Oh, right, solar panels. So we could make these easy. A generator's cheap. The problem with the generators, I do have to do the batteries, period, but that's pretty cheap. It's not a problem. These are not bad. They just take silicon cells, which we get in an industrial centrifuge, which I think I haven't even actually built an industrial centrifuge yet. Can I make it in the... Yeah, I can make it in the electrolyzer anyway. That's what I'm going to do. So you just need sand and cells, and you get silicon and compressed air. So that would be easy to do. And then you put those in the blast furnace, and you get the silicon plates. So I can make those, and the glass panes. So this is easy. I got this, right? So then if we went to advanced, it requires these, which are actually not bad at either. Reinforced glass is just advanced alloy. You make 7 of them. I've got a lot of that stuff. So that would be fine. I have the advanced alloys. We could make solar panels. Advanced machine blocks and advanced circuits. So those we would have to have. But that's not a big deal. So actually, we could get to advanced solar pretty quick right now. And then we could start supplementing the whole system with EU, with electric engines, right? So, I mean, it's kind of interesting if you think about it. I might come full circle, go back to just solar, just line the friggin', it's already ugly, line the ceiling of the whole building with solar. And then in hybrid, take the lapis blocks, not a problem. That's our problem, right? Even to get one of these, I would need a couple of iridium plates. And it's interesting, I could probably actually get... No, I couldn't. I couldn't come anywhere close. I need 4 iridium ingots. I don't even have 4. So I couldn't even make one of those. I couldn't even make one of these plates, and I need 2. So I'm way, way away from that. And not to mention all this crap, right? Kind of makes you want to throw up a little bit. Anyway, so we're close. We could do these, and this would give us a pretty good start. I want to play with this a little bit, too. This is for... it's not thermal expansion. It's... factorization, I believe. That's factorization power, and use the lead wires and stuff. It's really fun. I don't know if you caught my FTB craft like server tutorial series. I made these to run a furnace heater, I believe. Does that sound right? Furnace heater. Yeah, furnace heater. One of these, which then I ran for a crucible, is that right? What's the, like... No, I can't remember what the thing is. Crystallizer, I think. Yeah, this thing, which is a really cool little machine. You can make, like, slime balls and stuff with this. This was really fun. So I made a crystallizer, and you have to have a furnace heater next to it and whatever. So I will actually probably get one of those in place just because it's really fun power. And I really like that factorization, the solar panels that they use. It's kind of cool. So let me do this. Let's look. One more thing. I guess this is what I was going to say. Machine casings. So the next level, I want to just play around with this. Like, can we just replace one of them and increase our output? So what if we wanted to make one reinforced? So we need an advanced machine block. Our alternative is, see, this is maybe where the steel machine hall would be a better, because we have steel. We could get 16 of these with some of this junk, and then we could just make a bunch of those with steel, huh? Reinforced machine. So we need that, and we need, see, this one takes more advanced circuitry. You got to have like a diamond or a pulsating chipset or diamond OR gate or whatever, or advanced circuit. So this is where I think I might go with an advanced circuit, and I might even go with an advanced machine block and some steel. So we could actually make 4 of those. I would like to try replacing 4 of these with, I'll try replacing some on the top and just see if that works, or if I have to replace an entire section. And I might even do some research. Let me go see what kind of time we have left, and I'll get us ready for that. I'll be right back. All right, guys. Well, we're already at 40 minutes, but I do have the answer. So I'm going to go ahead and call the video today. I do have the answer, though, and the answer is that it says on the wiki, industrial blast furnace can be made up of any, capital any, combination of machine casings. So I'm going to go ahead and make one recipe full of these, and they will increase my... Well, they'll increase my total by only 80. So I'll need to make two recipes to get 160, and I needed to get up to 1,700. 160 won't quite do it. I'll need to make three. Either that or I don't even think I can get any of the advanced. I need chrome. So you need to get to the next level before you can even get chrome, and then you got to get these insanity things. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to have to make three of these recipes, which I can totally do. Supposedly there's an alternative. Oh, there is. That's it right there. That is good. I'm going to do that. I didn't even know about the alternative. Oh, you can even... Okay. So this recipe here is an alternative advanced circuit recipe. It uses silicon plates. And the silicon plates we can make now pretty easily with the industrial blast furnace. We just need silicon cells, which we can make on our electrolyzer. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to get those ready. I'm going to use those advanced circuits with the silicon plate, and I'll get them ready and show you guys the recipe in the next episode. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Another 40-minute-plus episode. I apologize. It seems to be that K-Man is the only outstanding hater of my long episodes. He was threatening to riot last time and rip my legs off. I appreciate the fact that he didn't. So I hope you guys are enjoying it. I'm going to try to keep the next one short, even though that's what I was trying to do on this one as well. So I apologize, you guys, for that. And I hope you're enjoying them. Please leave comments and a thumbs up if you liked it. Tell your friends. Follow me on Twitter, MinecraftOTB. Any comments or tweets will be responded to for sure. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'm very proud of our new industrial blast furnace. We'll talk to you next time.